Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, my name is Viridiana and I like to make videos on lifestyle, on experiences that I've gone through in high school, college, and currently my adult life. So if you're interested in these kind of topics, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and let's get started. So in my last video, I actually talked about procrastination and how easy it is to procrastinate and fall behind when taking classes online. Today, I thought I could talk about different ways that I used to avoid procrastinating while I was a student. As some of you may know, I'm not a big procrastinator. I actually get super anxious when I procrastinate, so I avoid to do it as much as I can. There have been times where I do it, and again, I just get really anxious, and it's just a really bad experience overall. So yes, I like to be on top of my classwork, on top of my assignments. So yeah, that's usually why I avoid procrastinating. Also, my mom made it a habit where every time we came back home from school, we would do our homework. Because of that, I just kind of have always been that kind of person who does their assignments as soon as possible. So here are a few tips and tricks that I learned as a student and, you know, may be able to help you. The first bit of advice I would like to give is to write down your due dates. Whether this is on your planner, on your bullet journal, or, you know, Google calendars, write them down. This not only will make you more consciously aware of the assignments that you have, but also writing them down somewhere where you will be able to look at them every day will also remind you that these assignments are coming up. And I say to write these down because usually at schools, whether it's high school or college, you normally are given a syllabus unless you have a teacher or a professor who promises to give you a syllabus and they never do. Anyway, for the most part, teachers and professors usually give syllabi at the beginning of the school year, the course. And normally in these syllabi, you are able to find important tasks and assignments and their due dates. And yes, these due dates may change. You know, life happens, as we may know, Corona. And so you kind of just have to learn to adapt, but being able to write them down from the beginning will help you keep track of these assignments and they won't creep up on you. And you know, this actually can also be applicable for work. So what I used to like to do as a student is that I would like to write my due dates down in a red pen or highlight them with a pink highlighter because it's a very vibrant color and it would actually set them apart from my other tasks. Currently working in my job, I like to actually use sticky notes and write down any pressing deadlines or important projects that I'm working on and put them around my computer. And if you're someone that likes to keep everything digital, you can always use school calendar or a different type of calendar to be able to keep track of these deadlines. That's even better because, for example, Google Calendar has these features where it will remind you about that task and you can customize it to set it up, you know, a few hours before, a few days before, or even a few weeks before. So take advantage of those features in these different apps to be able to organize yourself better. So yeah, basically what I'm trying to say is to just write down these due dates and deadlines so you're aware of them and they just don't take you by surprise later. The second bit of advice that I would like to give is to set up a plan and break down these big assignments into smaller pieces. Now that you know when these due dates are, you can set up a plan according to your schedule. That way you don't have to leave it to last minute. For example, if you have a 10-page essay that's due a month from now, you know, write down the deadline and set up a plan. Breaking it into small pieces instead of leaving it for the last day or, you know, the night before will be much easier to actually accomplish. You can plan to brainstorm your idea today. You can plan to write the introduction tomorrow and then, you know, write another 3 pages the day after and etc., etc. But breaking it down into smaller pieces seems more manageable than writing this big 10-page paper. Not only will the goals you give yourself be less daunting than a big assignment, but you'll actually give yourself more time. And since it's not done last minute, you'll have time to review it, and you'll also make sure that you're turning in your best work. When I was writing my senior thesis for college, that's what I ended up doing. We had to do a scholarly essay that was 20 to 25 pages long. And I know for some people that might not seem like a lot actually, but writing a scholarly essay is actually kind of hard. So what I ended up doing is I broke it up into smaller pieces and then I accidentally ended up writing 35 pages and still had 3 weeks left before I had to turn it in. So not only did I finish with time to spare, but I was able to cut it back down to 25 pages and still review it thoroughly and have other people review it for me and just turn in an assignment that I was very proud of. So yeah, I would definitely recommend breaking up bigger assignments into smaller pieces and then setting up a plan for them. So you're not leaving everything to last minute and you're not procrastinating. Tip number 3, start the task. And I know this seems very straightforward and very easy to do, but usually starting the task is usually what's holding us back from actually completing the task. But half the time we end up procrastinating is because we haven't even started the task at all. We don't realize how easy the task is or how hard the task may be. I don't know if this has ever happened to you, but once you get started, you actually get into the zone. You know, you go ahead and study as much as you can, or you write as much as you can. Even if it's just writing down 3 sentences, at least it's better than nothing. You'll be able to pick up from where you left off, or you'll even be able to decide if you want to start from scratch again. But yes, if you haven't started your assignment, go ahead and start that as soon as possible. If you need to study for an exam, a way to avoid procrastinating and leaving studying to last minute is writing down key points of what the exam is going to be about. Or if it's an exam where you do more memorization, you know, making your flashcards. So that way, the tools that you need to study for this exam will already be ready, and all you have to do is actually study for the exam. But getting things started is usually the challenging part, so do it as soon as possible. Tip number 4. So like I said earlier, you start your assignment and you really get into the zone, right? Don't forget to actually take breaks. If you're the type of person who likes to go hours working, then make sure your breaks are longer. If you're the type of person who likes to work in intervals, then your breaks tend to be smaller, but make sure you're taking those breaks. I'm the type of person that likes to take longer breaks because I work for longer hours. I used to do about 30 minutes of whatever it is that I want. And normally this would mean I got to walk around for a bit. I got to, you know, get up and drink some water or go get some snacks or even go outside and get a little bit of fresh air. I would avoid going on my phone because especially if I have been looking for a screen for hours, I need to give my eyes that break as well. But sometimes I would go on social media, and that's fine. Like, use your break however you want. If you're gonna use it for a 20-minute nap, then take that 20-minute nap. But yeah, just make sure you're taking your breaks. There are also even apps that can help you take breaks and help you manage your time better. And I don't have any apps to recommend because I never use them, but if you do have any recommendations for these type of apps, go ahead and drop them in the comments so we can help each other out. But I can't emphasize how important it is to take breaks. If you don't take breaks, you're going to burn out. Why do you think that writing a 5-page essay the night before it's due is usually really hard to write? You'll be on the last page and don't know what to write anymore. It's because you've been working for so long that you actually end up burning out, and all you actually really need was just a break. Give your brain a break, get some water, get some food, get some rest. Just make sure you're taking your breaks and taking care of yourself as well. And my last tip to avoid procrastinating is setting up a work environment where you won't get distracted. And I know this can be a little bit harder now with COVID going around. We may not have it in our capabilities to be able to set up a work environment, but do your best you can. I know that personally, for me as a student, I would never actually be able to study with others. And that's because I would start talking to them, and not only would I distract myself, but I would also distract them. So for me, I actually need to be alone when I study or when I'm doing really important assignments, so I avoid any kind of distractions. I would like to go to a library or to a cafe or even just sit outside and have that background noise going on. And if I didn't have background noise, I would just put, you know, like those lo-fi beats, that girl writing in her journal, if you know what channel I'm talking about. But there are people who actually can't work in libraries or who work better in their rooms or, you know, just work better in different environments. And that's okay. Like, everyone's work environment is different. So like I said, it might be a little bit harder to actually accomplish this right now. One thing I would recommend for people who are like me and need that kind of solitude space, if you don't have that option of going to a different room, literally sit facing a wall. Or if you know you need to sit outside instead, go and sit outside. You know, keep your distance obviously and make sure you're being safe and just do what's best for you. But create a work environment with minimal distractions so you're able to complete your assignments and not procrastinate. So those are some of the tips that I used as a student and I'm still currently using now to avoid procrastinating. If you have any tips of your own, go ahead and drop them down in the comment section so we're able to help each other out. Please make sure to like this video if you haven't already, and I'll go ahead and see you next time. Bye-bye!